Hello students, I, Sheetal Barya from Saraswat International Academy, welcome you to the science class. Chapter number 4, part 4, heat. In this session, we shall continue with the notes of chapter 4, heat. Question, describe the following experiments with diagram. First one, to observe the flow of heat through solid object, a metal. Apparatus and material needed, rod or flat strip of aluminium or iron, wax pieces, candle, two bricks. Procedure, first point, take a rod or flat strip of aluminium or iron. Second point, fix a few small wax pieces by heating on the metal rod. Their pieces should be at nearly equal distance. Children, this is the diagram you have to draw in your book. Third point, clamp the rod to a stand or put one end of the rod in between the bricks in horizontal direction in such a way that the wax pieces must remain beneath the rod. You can see in the picture the same way. Now heat the other end of the rod with the help of a candle. Observation. Wax pieces start melting. Wax piece closest to the heating end of the rod falls first. After that, the second nearest wax piece and so on. Heat is transferred from one end nearest to the flame to the other end. Conclusion. Heat travels in metal through conduction. Heat flows from the hotter end to the of the object to the colder end. Of heat by convection in water. Apparatus and material. A round bottom glass flask, water, tripod stand, wire gauze, Bunsen burner, potassium permanganate, straw. Label the diagram as shown in the diagram. Procedure. Number one. Take a round bottom glass flask. Fill it two-third with water. Place it on a tripod with wire gauze and arrange the Bunsen burner just below it. Wait till the water in the flask is still. Place a crystal of potassium permanganate gently at the bottom of flask using a straw. Heat the flask. Observation. When violet colored water is heated, the colored water near the flame becomes hot. Hot water rises up. To take its place of that water, the cold water from the sides move downward towards the source of heat. This water also gets hot and rises, and water from the sides move down. Due to violet color, currents of water going up and down can be clearly visible. This process continues till the whole water gets heated. After some time, whole water turns violet color. Conclusion: heat is transferred in water by convection. Next question, explain giving scientific reason. First one, there is a kink constriction near the mercury bulb in the capillary tube of clinical thermometer. Mercury rises in the capillary tube during the measurement of temperature of the patient. Now, due to kink or constriction, the mercury itself does not fall down. So, after removing the thermometer from the contact of the patient's body, mercury remains steady at that level. Therefore, the body temperature of the patient can be read even after some time. It is not advisable to wash the clinical thermometer with hot water. Answer. The clinical thermometer can measure temperature from 35 degrees to 42 degrees Celsius. Second point, the temperature of hot water is more than 42 degrees Celsius. So, if we wash the thermometer with hot water, then mercury expands in the capillary tube above 42 degrees and hence it will break the tube. So, clinical thermometer cannot be washed with hot water. Question number 3. Metal utensils are used for cooking. Metal is a good conductor of heat, so it absorbs heat from the stove rapidly and becomes hot. So, heat is supplied speedily to the food material kept in the utensil. So, the food is prepared quickly, hence metal utensils are used for cooking. Number 4. Ice is kept in sawdust. Sawdust is a bad conductor of heat. When ice is kept in sawdust, heat of atmosphere cannot pass to the ice and hence ice does not melt rapidly. So ice is kept in sawdust. Question number 5. Handles of pressure cooker are made of ebonite. First point, as the pressure cooker is used to cook the food, it is made of good conductor of heat. Pressure cooker cannot be handled directly as it becomes too hot when it is heated. But as handles are made of ebonite, heat does not pass through the handles, because ebonite is a bad conductor of heat. So we cannot handle the pressure cooker safely and easily with our bare hands. Hence, handles of the pressure cooker are made of ebonite. Next question, number 6. The inner side of the jacket is made of fur. Fur is a bad conductor of heat. The inner side of the jacket is made of fur to prevent body heat from escaping and keeping the body warm. Number 7. Mercury is used in the thermometers. Mercury remains liquid for a wide range of temperature. It has a fairly uniform rate of expansion for a wide range of temperature. It does not stick to the walls of the thermometer, which are made of glass. It can be seen easily in the thin glass tube of a thermometer as it has silvery gray color. Mercury can be easily collected when thermometer breaks. So, mercury is used in thermometers. Next question, answer in details. Draw the diagram of clinical thermometer and explain its construction and working. Clinical thermometer. It is used to measure the temperature of a human body. Here is the diagram. Construction. It consists of a long, narrow, uniform glass tube which has capillary tube in which mercury runs. It has a bulb at one end and it is connected with the capillary tube. Bulb contains mercury which expands or contracts as the temperature around the bulb changes. There is a scale on the thermometer The scale we use is the Celsius scale, indicated by degree C. In a clinical thermometer, the range of temperature is from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius or from 94 degrees Fahrenheit to 110 degrees Fahrenheit. There is a kink or small constriction at the bottom of the capillary tube near the bulb of the thermometer. Kink or the small constriction prevents mercury level from falling down on its own. There is a red arrow mark at 37 degrees Celsius temperature. Working. First of all, wash the clinical thermometer with an antiseptic solution. Hold it firmly and give it a few jerks to bring the level of mercury below 35 degrees Celsius. Then, after, hold the bulb of the thermometer under your tongue for 1 minute. After 1 minute, take out the thermometer from your mouth and note the reading, which shows the temperature of your body. Next, question number 2. Draw the diagram of laboratory thermometer and explain its construction and working. Laboratory thermometer. It is used to measure the temperature of objects with greater precision in laboratory. Construction. Here is the diagram. It consists of a very long, narrow, uniform glass tube which has capillary tube in which mercury runs. At one end of the capillary tube, there is a cylindrical tip-type arrangement like a bulb bulge out. This bulb contains mercury which expands or contracts as the temperature around the bulb changes. There is a scale on thermometer. The range of laboratory thermometer is generally from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Working of the laboratory thermometer. Put the laboratory thermometer in the substance in such a way that the bulb of the thermometer should be completely surrounded by the substance whose temperature is to be measured. Make sure that the bulb should not touch the bottom or sides of the container. Hold the thermometer vertically for a while and observe the movement of the mercury level in the thermometer. Wait till the mercury level becomes steady and note down the reading of the thermometer. This observation shows the temperature of that substance. Explain sea breeze and land breeze with necessary figures. The people living in the coastal areas experience an interesting phenomenon created due to the natural convection. Sea breeze. In coastal regions, the sun gives equal amount of heat energy to the land surface as well as the seawater. During the day, the temperature of the land rises more rapidly as compared to the seawater. Hence, the air above the land becomes hot and rises up. The cooler air from the sea starts blowing towards the land to take its place. At the same time, the warm air from the land moves towards the sea to complete the cycle. The air from the sea is called sea breeze. Land breeze. During the night, the land as well as the sea water cools down, but the temperature of the land falls more rapidly as compared to the sea water. Therefore, at night, the temperature of the sea water is more than the land. Hence, at night, cool air starts moving from the land towards the sea. This is called the land breeze. Question number 4. State similarities and differences between the laboratory thermometer and the clinical thermometer. The similarities and differences between the laboratory thermometer and clinical thermometer are as follows. Similarities. Mercury is used in both thermometers. Both have long narrow glass tube of same thickness. In both thermometers, there would be construction like a bulb at the one end of the tube. Differences. First one, there is no kink in the narrow tube of the laboratory thermometer, while there is a kink in narrow tube of the clinical thermometer near the bulb filled with mercury. Second, the range of the laboratory thermometer is generally from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius, while a clinical thermometer reads temperature from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. Third difference, laboratory thermometer is used to measure the temperature of objects in the laboratory, while clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of